Dr. Scheibner, if you can just very quickly, because we are running out of time, tell us about the vaccine situation in your country, Australia. Do they give out vaccines annually? Do they make people take vaccines?
Well, first of all, I must say that with this current flu debacle, which it no doubt will be, the media and the government is playing it down. They are actually telling people not to panic, not to buy Tamiflu, not to go and try to get any flu vaccines, etc. They even issued a statement that not a single case of this new flu has been identified. So they are definitely playing it down. And you don't see any nasal masks wearing or any nonsense of that kind. Australians are also less susceptible to this type of hype. And our politicians, I must say, to their credit, are definitely playing it down. Now, as far as admitting serious reactions to vaccinations and what sort of vaccination is administered here, it is the same for babies. It is the same as anywhere else. You know, multiple vaccines, six vaccines or advanced session. And they are causing death and all those modern ills of children. But the Australian Immunization Handbook, which is issued by the Federal Health Department, lists four pages densely written of reactions, which include death. And all those serious reactions, brain damage, and blood disorders, etc. So it is actually mandated by law. The law about medical negligence clearly stipulates that doctors and all those who distribute or sell or produce any pharmaceutical products, including vaccines, must warn of all side effects, no matter how rare,
okay.
And even when the patient does not ask.
All right, we're going to go ahead and take some...
Australian culture is a little bit different.
Okay, we're going to take some phone calls. Actually, someone is asking, and I'm just going to have him take this off the air, has aspirin worsened the pandemic? Dr. Horowitz, can you answer that, like yes or no, very quickly?
Well, you know, ascorbic acid, you know, aspirins in general are acidifiers. So my family does not take any aspirin even. We have three beautiful children, not one vaccinated, and my oldest is in the studio with us. She's 16 years old. She has never taken one aspirin, not one antibiotic, not one pharmaceutical. And, you know, we do treat things exactly like Dr.
And I can tell you, she's gorgeous. Her eyes are clear. Her skin is clear. She's absolutely
radiant. She's a sweetheart.
Radiant.
She wrote her first book at age 9. She's brilliant, and she's tremendously blessed. The reality is that if we simply watch our body chemistry, and we do the right things to our body to maintain our immunity. And that is simply smart living, smart diet, and avoiding the environmental risks. And that's a challenge in today's world.
Okay. We're going to try to get in two calls real quick. I always say I'm going to take calls the whole show coming up. Okay. Can we talk to Jim from Long Beach? Jim, you've got to make it like 15 seconds. Your question.
Excellent. Thanks for the natural healing element. And
sure.
I wonder if you can connect chemtrails with the social engineering you're talking about, because they've been very heavy and well, anyway, that's my question.
They have been. And we're going to do a show coming up on that because great question. Dr. Horowitz, 30 seconds.
Yeah, I read a book called Death in the Air, Globalism, Terrorism, and Toxic Warfare. It came out 3 months before September 11th. Think of the title, Death in the Air, Globalism, Terrorism, and Toxic Warfare. Few people were talking about that then. I wrote that book, and I have a full 60-page chapter on chemtrails. It's very important to read.
Okay, line 5, we're going to go ahead and talk to Craig at L.A., if you can make it in 10 seconds, your question.
Of course, yes, very quick. Yes, I just wanted to say there is a connection between the chemtrails. I live here in Hollywood, and they've increased a lot. I've even seen helicopters. It seems like they're taking air samples, and the chemtrails are really thick here. And
they're doing it at nighttime now, too.
Right, right.
Mm-hmm.
And I wanted to ask the panels if they think there's a chance of this virus increasing, and I'll take my answer off the air.
Okay, thanks. And we only have like 10 seconds.
Okay, yes, I think that there's all sorts of things coming, bioterrorism, biowarfare. Yes, the chemtrails are associated with chemical intoxication, immune suppression, and if your immune gets suppressed from the chemtrail sprays, then that leaves you more susceptible to the infectious diseases. That is classic Russian biological cocktail method of producing covert operations and this whole revolution in military affairs leading to depopulation.
Okay, Dr. Scheibner, if you have, in closing, just 10 seconds.
Yes, it is a question of not destroying our immunity. Let nature do its own thing, and that means no vaccines, no medications. And one more comment. I talked about vitamin C, sodium ascorbate, not the acidic form.
Okay, what right. I'll do is I'm going to list those. I'm going to type those on the website for all the listeners because I want to have the answers out there for you. So I'm going to add that this evening, all of the solutions to get your immune system strong so you can fight all of this off. And I want to thank you, Dr. Viera Scheibner from Australia, joining us here on the line, Dr. Leonard Horowitz, and we're going to have a link to his YouTube also so you can hear more of what he has to say, his news release that just came out. Please make sure to log on to our new website. Everybody, tell your friends and family. Go to our website, or you can even email us at sherrybeall.com, SHERRYBEALL, info@sherrybeall.com. Thank you to our guests. Thanks to G for engineering, Albert Attree for production assistance, Vito D'Ambrosio, our producer, Carrie Williams, our news producer, Ali Lexa for music, Alan Simmons, thank you very much for your production assistant and making the show happen today, and certainly to you, our listeners. Make sure again to log on, and we're going to have the show posted shortly on YouTube, on our Healthy Planet, Healthy Me page on YouTube. We'll talk to you next week. And in the meantime, let's all create a healthy planet, healthy me.